Hey everybody, it's Rocket Brown, Ranger Crow. We're back with, what was it called?
What makes a Sonic game work?
Oh, okay.
Is that what I said last time?
Yeah,
Well,
what makes a Sonic
then
game?
it's gonna be a million different titles of what makes a Sonic game work, what makes a Sonic game good, how to make Sonic game, Sonic game, question mark, and other titles. So let's just stick with this for now. What makes a Sonic game work? We
No,
talked about
that's perfectly
character development
fine.
of Sonic and Tails last episode, so this time we're gonna talk about the rival Knuckles the Echidna, my personal favorite.
Well,
and as a character in the Sonic universe and how he's fallen to obscurity. depresses me. It really does.
He used to be my... Well, actually, if I had to name my favorite Sonic characters, it would be Sonic, Knuckles, and Metal Sonic.
Those are good characters.
Yeah.
There is good characters. But, okay. So, do you have an original bio for Knuckles, or should I just go?
Oh, he has a bio.
All right, well, let's read that off. Let's see what Sega had with the little fancy notes and notepad.
Yeah, he was actually younger than Sonic.
Yeah, he was 15.
Strong port, he could dig holes and climb cliffs with his spike knuckles. He also has the ability to glide through the air using his hair, which is freaking awesome.
Oh, yeah.
His weak point was girls. He's a shy guy.
Oh.
He likes fruit and digging holes, and he dislikes strong sunshine.
Yeah.
So he was kind of a mysterious guy who hid in the shadows and stuff.
Yep.
So he probably didn't like come out that much.
Nope, because he's always lurking around, making sure nobody's touching his giant emeralds. Now, Knuckles, you could delve a lot from Knuckles just from Sonic 3 alone.
Actually, you're right.
Because unlike a lot of characters, Knuckles is the only one who started off, like, physically, at least ability-wise, on par with Sonic. Or, hell, on par with Super Sonic.
I was going to say on par with Super Sonic, because the first thing you see him do before the game even starts is sucker punch him.
From the ground, steal his emerald, and run off. While Sonic is left to lick his wounds. This immediately started to me one of the original famous rivalries from that old school 16-bit, 8-bit, whatever you want to call it, era of video gaming. And, you know, you always had your famous rivalries, you know.
You had Proto Man, you had Ridley, and then you had Knuckles.
Exactly. Knuckles was just always one step ahead of you, always making, like, you know, traps for you and always fucking you up. So he obviously seemed like a clever guy, or at least clever enough that he knew the layout of the land.
Right, because was his home.
Knuckles, not retarded. Keep that in mind, because I'm going to bring that back later.
Okay, I was going to say, you're going to talk about it later. That's fine.
Yeah, I'm going to talk about how he's not retarded later. Knuckles' personality traits, or at least what I've gathered from him, he's a savage. He's a total savage. Grows up in an area that's not inhabited by cities or severe amount of technology, at least in video game universe, not comic universe.
Uh-huh.
Very strong physically as well as mentally, because he obviously must have a shitload of discipline to sit and watch a giant jewel for hours on end. So, right. He is kind of like Sonic's serious point, not his level of reason, not his voice reason, but he is serious Sonic.
Right.
Your martial arts background, completely disciplined, almost like a military guy in a sense.
Yeah, and because he was kind of, he lived on the island all of his life, he's not really used to deception. He grew up believing, you know, on it, and like
your
utmost honesty. Yeah.
Yeah. So he is the definition of the noble savage.
Yeah.
I would think Knuckles' weak points are, obviously, he doesn't know deception, meaning that he is too trusting with people, and that shows. It shows that he's gotten tricked by Robotnik multiple times. In three games?
No, okay. He got tricked. I was actually going to bring this up, because this actually started even before, like, the 3D update, because he got tricked in... Sonic 3 and Knuckles, of course.
Yes.
And then that became the plot point again in Sonic Triple Trouble.
Yeah, I was about to bring that up.
Which doesn't even make any sense, because I think he said Sonic was after the Chaos Emeralds and was trying to conquer the world. And he already told him, and this, keep in mind, this is after the Egg Robos came back and set a bomb in, right up in his face.
right. After and the Sonic Knuckles.
Yeah, this is after the Knuckles part in Sonic and Knuckles, so that's kind of weird.
It was a little weird, but then again, Sonic Triple Trouble and a lot of those Game Gear games seemed kind of off.
When it came to
keeping the characters in line.
Well, I always assumed them as just side stories.
Maybe. And then, same thing happened in Sonic Adventure 1.
Adventure 1, it was kind of... I tolerated it in Adventure 1 only because that was my first experience with Knuckles, so I didn't really realize...
I actually thought it worked because the only thing he could go off of was what he saw, and he saw Sonic holding green jewel thingy, so he
let right.
that be his. But, that Knuckles is, that's one of Knuckles' weak characteristics. Another one, I guess, if you wanted to go into the physical aspect, is that he's not as fast as Sonic.
And then in, Sonic Advance 2, they literally just do it for laughs.
Yeah.
Like, Sonic Advance 2, Sonic's just literally like, you got tricked again, didn't you?
It becomes not funny after a while, I'm not gonna lie.
Well, it wasn't funny. It was just kind of like, really? Really? This really happened?
Yeah.
This happened in the Sky Canyon Zone.
Yeah, I remember. But Knuckles' character is... It's like the polar opposite of Sonic, almost, in a sense. You know, you got free spirit kind of guy versus very very HQ-driven. Like, he's like, this is my home, I defend this, blah, 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 blah.
Right.
Now, this is portrayed now, and this is why I said Knuckles is not retard. Knuckles is retard now. Knuckles.
I blame the show, to be perfectly honest.
Oh, I accept that. I accept that as blame. That's one of the many things I blame nowadays.
Because at first, like, you watch some episodes, and it's like, okay, this is kind of Knuckles. And then there's just episodes where it's like, really?
It's really after the first story arc. The first story arc, him and Rouge, like, punched down that steel door and stuff like that, that's when things went really weird, and Knuckles became just like, I put Sonic. Like, no common sense, no intellect, anything whatsoever. Knuckles gets battered around and abused, like, by these characters in more ways than not. A prime example is, I want to take Sonic Riders, and I know this is a really bad game to use as an example, but
I think it's the perfect use.
And Knuckles is like, his head is literally spinning.
I know, he's like, that's enough. It floats.
Don't care.
That's all I need to know.
You would think that he'd want to know at least a little bit how this worked, because it's kind of a product of ancient technology.
Yeah.
But no.
And it's like, so you don't know how to use the flying things in Marble Garden? Sky Sanctuary?
You know, your echidnas built technological marvels, but whatever.
They built Casinopolis.
Yeah. Knuckles' rivalry between Sonic is almost a non-existent thing now. I honestly think his rivalry with Sonic is non-existent.
They don't bring it back until Sonic Rivals, and that's the only game.
Yeah, and even then, it's like, Knuckles' rivalry with Sonic is almost a joke now. They've physically nerfed him. They've made him very, 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 very slow, but I could probably outrun him running backwards while drinking a fifth of Jack Daniels. He's incredibly unintelligent, like, whatsoever. Yes, he's a very strong guy, but it makes him, like... Yes, he was always considered the muscle of the group, but they made him literally the muscle of the group, to where he's like giant roid man who can't really wipe his ass properly. Sonic and Knuckles were always supposed to be the kind of guys who'd be like, yeah, we're cool with each other, but that doesn't mean we're going to go to parties with each other and shit, and, you know, Knuckles won't be chasing around with Sonic all the time.
Right.
Because Knuckles' primary focus is always the Master Emerald. But games, they take him out of that element, and I think that started with Sonic Heroes, where it's like, oh, I'm just chilling and Tails is playing, you know, because... Or like in Sonic Riders, oh, I'm just chilling in the back of this car, because... you know, reason.
So Living I'm in here the hanging city, out you know court. You have to survive.
No, shut no, up.
I'm kidding. No, but I completely agree. No, I love it too, but
Or like, I'm chilling at Sonic's birthday party because reason.
No, and for that matter, Blaze, don't you have emeralds to guard? Have we'll you forgotten your Blaze. Duties?
We'll talk about her in another episode. But, Knuckles, I hate to say it, but you have been completely abused by Sega. You should really seek rival help.
I think you would like him so much in the European comics.
Oh, I'm sure I will. I'm sure I like him in most of the comics anyway, because they give him at least a dynamic personality. Knuckles has traits that Sonic doesn't have. Knuckles is a patient. Let's be right up there. Knuckles is a patient person. Knuckles can sit still for more than 5 seconds. Knuckles has discipline. These are all traits that Sonic does not have at all, which made him work as the character. So when they did team up, you had, like, Sonic, Tails, and Knuckles, and they're all differently in dynamic ways. But, let's...
Actually, I actually wanted to point out, just, like, once again, going... That it's really sad that the comic book characters have better personality than the game characters, because, just keep in mind, and it's known as the publisher was known as Fleetway for the European comics.
Mm-hmm.
Knuckles is pretty much... He's pretty similar to the Archie Knuckles, only a bit smarter, because... He's not only to trick Robotnik on several occasions. He also there's a point in the comic where the Master Emerald is destroyed, and basically what happens is Knuckles the Echidna travels the globe and rebuilds a new Master Emerald on his own.
Knuckles the Echidna, a badass mofo.
I'll send you a link to the picture, but yeah, like Knuckles, he was pretty much like a Clint Eastwood character almost.
And I like that.